fit anywhere. Like, we've always been really hard to place in any sort of wider scheme of things, but it hasn't mattered because we've just done our own thing and managed to make it work. Well, when we first started the band, I think I expected it to last like a handful of gigs. I didn't really think beyond just playing a gig. Thinking too far ahead of that seemed maybe unrealistic.
I think after 20 years, the most thing I'd be proud of is something that Katie's voice stuck to what we wanted to do. We've never really bowed down to anyone or anything. Hey, when Steph joined the band back in, was it 98? It was quite an intense band to be in back then, and I think she kind of brought just a nice calming vibe, which we needed.
Among other things, she's the best bass player I've ever met. She's amazing. When she sets her mind to something, it's just like, get out of the way.
Something for Kate recently had a change in lineup. Paul Dempsey spoke to us this week to tell us exactly what's going on.
We've had a bit of a lineup change. Toby, who was our second bass player, has quit the band. And so now we have Stephanie Ashworth, who also plays in Sandpit.
You know, it was a fairly masculine band when I, you know, took over bass duties, so that was a little bit intimidating. The first time I saw something for Kate, a particular show that I saw, Paul was having quite a moment on stage and he was throwing his guitar around. I think he threw his guitar at Clint, he screamed at Julian. It looked like quite an intense environment, and I remember saying to my guitarist at the time, oh, you know, I would never want to be in that band, my God. It's 9 months or so later I was in that band. To get to play those songs, I've always felt incredibly lucky.
Was play music, but I guess I always just assumed that I would have to have another job. I just grew up in a house where everyone was making music all the time. I don't remember a moment where there was a decision to make music. It was just sort of the norm.
I guess I hadn't really intended to be in a band. I kind of fell into it, and I ended up finding myself having to choose between my studies and music. Without any sort of doubt, I chose music.
I always wanted to be in a band. I think it's always stemmed from seeing Tico Torres from Bon Jovi play drums.
My name's Clint, I play drums. I used to be a big Bon Jovi fan and saw Tico Torres and I wanted to do that.
The only way you could find out about, you know, underground music was through the sort of network of word of mouth or by going to these sort of all ages shows.
It was very much about word of mouth and zines.
Even just meeting people who liked the same kind of music you did, because you couldn't find each other on the internet. That was like meeting your long lost twin. When we first started touring, we were just kids let loose with a rental car.
In the Tarago, we used to have to try and, there's no road cases or anything, we put the drums inside the drums inside the drums, trying to fit as much as we could in the Tarago.
Like, we still didn't know how to play. It was sort of, I guess when we first started touring, it was still almost like we were just going to school each week or something.
Official fiction. Officiellement, ça sonne comme du Something for Kids.
Es ist allerhöchste Zeit. Something for Kids sind Paul, Stephanie und Clint.
There's one thing I wish I'd done was wear earplugs.
Wear earplugs?
Earplugs, yeah. You know, tell my younger self to relax a bit. I can really see now that when I was younger, dealing with the media, I would be a bit kind of edgy and a bit defensive. I may have got a reputation for being somewhat difficult.
Here's a song from Grumpy, another trio, something.
Yeah, you know, I was young, I was a kid.
Process for Something for Kate has changed a lot. So we used to agonise for, you know, 2 years at a time, pulling things apart and then rebuilding them.
Some have been easier than others and some have been longer, but it feels like it's getting easier again.
I mean, try and get three painters to paint a picture together on the one canvas.
We just realised that it was better for us not to procrastinate so much. We trust ourselves a little bit more.
The last album in particular, Leave Yourself to Science, was written and recorded in the shortest space we've ever done. It's not so much that there was a definite aesthetic vision. My handwriting or my sketches, it became the sort of look of the band. We sort of kept that thread running through it.
Because you work so hard on the music that you don't want to have a disconnect between that and, you know, and the visuals. We always try to be very hands-on with that.
A lot of people couldn't bop their head in time with Something for Kate stuff. I think we were one of those bands that was almost too indie for commercial radio and too commercial for indie radio a lot of the time.
Realise that there is room in music for every topic. And they don't have to all be about cars and girls and rock and roll, and that's where we come in, because they're not.
We would play anywhere, anytime.
Doing in-stores is something that we did a hell of a lot back in the day, and I think it was something that was quite fun because you got to meet the people who were buying your records. It's one of the sad things about record stores not being around so much anymore.
The guy flashing his pearly whites in the clip was actually drummer Clint Hindman.
When I saw that video, it was amazing. She wants to be perfect, the
Sharks is simply brilliant. Just listen to the exciting sound of Something for Kate. Limited edition live CD free with CDs for less than the price of one.
One of the great Aussie bands.
Terrific Melbourne band.
Great Australian group.
Hopefully they're ready. Paul, you tall man in bare feet. They're a great band.
One band that has had amazing success. We're very proud of them.
Please welcome
Something for Kate.
Hi, we are Something for Kate and we will be playing live tonight.
We only ever played on the shows that could accommodate, you know, a completely live performance. And, you know, there used to be more of them. It's a bit of a pity that there's not anymore.
I feel really sad and nostalgic for the time that we had TV shows like Recovery. It's a huge gap where that was.
We're lucky to have such a loyal audience.
Haircuts.
You can almost chart the band's history just by looking at Clint's hairstyle.
The worst thing is an electricity video, three-quarter length pants and an odd shirt and a bull necklace with black hair. Terrible.
short, kind of spiky, pinkish red hair, like one of those little dolls that you stick on your dashboard.
Green dreadlocks, blue dreadlocks, red dreadlocks, bleach blonde hair.
I enjoyed the blonde face.
Shaved head, spiky bleach blonde hair, a kind of stylish pushed forward haircut, eyebrow ring, no beard, beard, mustache, ball necklace, tattoos, still tattoos.
His hair now is probably, it probably suits him the most.
Got it right, finally.
I left school and started the band straight away, and you know, here we are. There just wasn't time for anything else. We got so busy so fast, and we couldn't believe it, so obviously it wouldn't change a thing. And there you go. You know, Clint is my oldest and best friend.
They're a pair of brothers. Like, Clint's the younger brother and Paul's the older brother.
Stephanie's like a sister to me. She always looks out for me, which is something I need.
There is barely a thing that I attempt in my life without consulting Paul and Clint. I don't know what I would have done without the two of them.
This band is literally a combination of like best friends and family.
I feel like, you know, I got in the Tarago with those two and we started driving up the Hume Highway to Sydney and having a blast. It doesn't feel like 20 years. I mean, as cliche as it sounds, I really feel like that was only a couple of years ago, so it's quite bizarre to me.
Definitely doesn't feel like that long, which is great, because I think the next 20 will probably go nice and quick.
Yeah, I don't know where that time's gone. Everything still feels new to me. I'm proud of the fact that I feel like each record has been a progression better than the one before it. We're here and we're still enjoying ourselves as much as we ever had, in fact, more so.